So I'll be sure to tell you when to sit or stand, and it's your choice about kneeling. As Catholics, we work for our salvation. There's an awful lot of work when you go to church. But I want you to know you're welcome here, and just be yourself and be at peace, and just pray. In baptism, Elaine died with Christ. May she rise with Christ to share in his eternal life. We ask this in the name of Jesus, our Savior. Amen. I was lost and now I'm found. I was blind and yet I see. I'm speaking of Gail Fenger. Where has she been since 2019? Well, she must have been doing the work of God, because here she is. And Elaine and Gail are together here in life as they were, and in death, and in now in eternal life. I will always miss them. They have been a beautiful couple and friends to me. Jerry is here today, who is the other half of Elaine. For when you saw one, you saw the other. And Jerry is a special friend of mine and of our church. And when he comes to Mass, it's a question, who's in charge here, Jerry or me? There's a little fight going on. And what does Elaine do? She just laughs about the whole thing. I know that laugh. You all know that laugh, right? Just try it in an amplified church. See, so many of you are here today from so many walks of life, I'm certain. And I'm sure that you also represent many of the causes and concerns that so define Elaine and Gail's life. I'm glad to see the pets here. I'm the blesser of pets as well. Pets always make us better people. They bring out the best in us, and they let us know when we're over the top. Have you noticed? Your pet kind of does this when you're going crazy. That's what's needed at a time like this. So here the whole family is together. We thank Barbara for all that she has done to prepare this day, to make it beautiful for you, for all of you, and for those who are joining us on this telecast. Aren't we all accustomed to the telecast at this point? I've become a preacher to the airwaves. I'll be glad when they close down. I don't want to be associated with those TV evangelists. And I promised you I'll not pass the hat today, and I'll not sell you a tape or a motivational video. We're just here to pray for our friends. That's the common bond that we have. And we've all had a share and a taste of their goodness. And I hope that you will, as I do, when you recollect Elaine to your mind, that you do so with gladness and joy, with a sense of thanksgiving, not with loss. Let's try to be like Jerry. He's kind of, what is this? I said, well, it's nothing important. I said, we're just moving from one place to the next. And it's a brief period of time here. And I think he's accepting that. And I'm asking God to help me accept that, as he does. He's just a giver. Can you imagine how it is to be in the presence of someone who's constantly turned on and giving? It'll wear you out. That's what it'll do. And I just thank Elaine for the patience of Job that she must have had. And every person who has the gift and the responsibility to care for another person who has special challenges in being in this world, where they're often forgotten and not welcome, and where their presence is not seen as a blessing, but more of a problem. She believed, I think you do too, that every person is a gift, and it's our responsibility to bring out the best of them as they are able to express it. Not what we want, but what they are. And when we do that, a job has been well done. Well done, Gail. Well done, Elaine. As we prepare now to offer sacrifice, I think we need to pause and ask God's pardon for our own failures, blindnesses, faults. And let's ask God a pardon and also Elaine, if we failed her in any way along the way. I confess to Almighty God, to you, my brothers and sisters, that I've greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I've done and what I have failed to do through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, pray for me to the Lord our God. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, bring us to everlasting life. Amen. And now let us pray. Heavenly Father, we commend to you our sister Elaine with gratitude and joy. Put heavenly burden on this occasion of her passing from us to you. As we release her from loving arms, we commend her to your loving care. And from her place in heaven, watch over us and guide us still. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Please be seated, folks.
Barbara.
Barbara, you can't rest. The first reading.
Of Sirach. Now will I praise those godly men and women, our ancestors, each in their own time. These were godly people whose virtues have not been forgotten. Their wealth remains in their families, endures their posterity for their sake. And for all time, their progeny will endure. Their glory will never be blotted out. Their bodies are peacefully laid away, but their name lives on and on. At gatherings, their wisdom is retold, and the assembly proclaims their praise. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Thank you, Barbara.
Thank you.
every time I remember you. In all my prayers for all of you, I always pray with joy because of your partnership in the gospel from the first day until now, being confident of this, that he who began a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus. It is right for me to feel this way about all of you, since I have you in my heart, and whether I am in chains or defending and confirming the gospel, all of you share in God's grace with me. God can testify how I long for all of you with the affection of Christ Jesus. And this is my prayer, that your love may abound more and more in knowledge and depth of insight, so that you may be able to discern what is best and may be pure and blameless for the day of Christ, filled with the fruit of righteousness that comes through Jesus Christ, to the glory and praise of God, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand with us for the reading of the gospel. Lord be with you. This comes from the Gospel according to St. Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. It's from the end of the story of the prodigal son. And the boy has finally come to himself and coming home. And he arose and he came to his father. But while he was yet at a distance, his father saw him and had compassion and ran and embraced him and kissed him. And the boy said to him, "Father, I've sinned against heaven and against you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son." But the father said to the servants, "Quickly now, bring a robe and put it on him. Put a ring on his finger, shoes upon his feet, and bring the fatted calf, and let us eat and make merry, for this son of mine was dead and is alive again. He was lost and he's now found." And they began to make merry. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. This is like a catechism for you. We'll make the sign of the cross a few more times before we're finished. I think I'd better start responding to myself so then I make sure I get the right answer. I do that often. I offer Mass, the prayer of the church. Someone asks me to pray for a friend or a loved one, and I'll often be the only one there. These days that we've gone through that are so very strange. A preacher without a congregation is a very strange existence, because we're not sitting in the same pew, but we're connected. And any real preacher is in a dialogue with you, at least emotionally. And Barbara's trying to read, and you're back there holding your heart. Will she make it through this? And tears are already coming. I want you to know I chose that. I ran across the way to find that. Every time I think of you with joy. And I want to thank you for your partnership from the very first day until the last. And it's right for me to feel this way about you because I hold you in my heart. Well, that's how we feel about her. And we suffer because Barbara suffers when she reads this. And you're in the place of suffering here. This is a chapel that is dedicated to the Holy Sepulchre, to the place where our Lord was taken down from the cross, where his mother was with him, placed in her arms, and then laid to rest in the tomb. All the things that we must do here. To have accompanied her, to have prepared her, and now to lay her in the tomb. But not alone. It's one thing we all deserve as people, that is to have company and comfort and care in this world from the moment of the beginning until the end. The arms of Our Lady are open. The mother of our Lord, our mother, the mother of the church. You can find your place there too. If you feel like you need to be able to go to your mother and find your comfort there, to go back, because it's been a long time, hasn't it? My hair is gone or gray, but I wish I would have to lay my head in my mother's lap and let her wipe away the gray. Turn back the years, because the world is way too heavy and with us now, especially today. I chose the reading of the prodigal because it describes my sister, my experience, and how it was that a member of my own family, because of her addiction, had been separated from us and had been virtually dead emotionally to my parents, to many people, because they didn't understand how times change. Alcoholism was considered in those days something of a moral weakness, not an illness. And because of that, there was a shame, a sense of self-consciousness, a desire to be hidden. She'd been gone for 30 years, and on around Easter, it had to be, because the dogwoods were blooming, and the azaleas were open, the daffodils were up. And you know that's the resurrection flower. It looks like a cross and it has wounds on it. It's a strange flower. And we had our chairs in the front yard. That's where we would sit in the cool of the evening. And there's Mama and Daddy and me there. Maybe someone from down the street. And up comes my sister. And I was stunned. We hadn't seen her in so long. And she said these words. I was dead, I'm now alive. I'm lost, but I'm found. Said, I cannot apologize for something before, I'm just here now. And that was all that was necessary, and she took her place in the chair as if she'd never been gone. I admire my parents for that, for their compassion. I wish they had done it sooner. What Elaine stood for, and I'm sure fought for, was that people who have disabilities or who have special challenges, intellectual, physical, emotional, mental, are not dead to us. Neither are they to be sheltered or hidden away. It's a lost life. Elaine, like many, are here to bring out the life in other people, to allow it to live. Without apology, without rancor, without hatred or bitterness, just let me live. And the experience of that is such a blessing. You can see why she and Gail were together. When we use the word, thank you for your partnership, it is a euphemism for the relationship that they've had. And I chose this for that reason. Because there's still so many people who require euphemisms in order to love someone. They don't need your permission, may I inform you. Love is a very strange thing. It's very blind. And you would never pick it for yourself, but there it is. And so you should rejoice whenever you see it. Gail was a guardian and was privileged to guide four people into the light. They raised furry children. I don't mean they had beards. They were another kind of child, a more demanding child, because they never grow up. If you ever want to be a mother or a father perpetually, then get a dog, get a cat, get something. There's no days off. Don't you love that commercial? There's no day off as mom or dad when you got to be there, whether you're sick or whether you're happy. But I'm certain that they're able to love those animals who love so unconditionally and without prejudice. That's why we're so easy to love an animal and so difficult sometimes to love a person. You got to get through so much in order to be able to even love them. But you can do it, and they teach you. And Gail is sitting out here. I loved her. When Elaine came and sat out here, she sat in the same place, by the way. You're all people of habits, so I know where you are. I can always look. And this is a church of thousands, and I will know when someone's not here. And I'll wonder, where are they? Where'd they go? Did I make them mad? But when Elaine was here with Jerry, it was bigger than life, louder than the microphone, and a beautiful encounter for me because I knew that they were coming for communion. And remember this: what this is an encounter between God and an individual. I'm just the mediator. I'm the witness. I'm the one who sets the table, but it's the Lord. And so I'm always amazed by the experience I see in Jerry getting communions, always an adventure. He's finally decided he was going to call me Dad. Hey, Dad. And this would be the encounter in front of 1,500 people on Sunday, being broadcast everywhere. And I'd say, hello, son. And give him communion. He's carrying on. I say, take communion now. Take communion. Elaine's just laughing the whole thing. She thought it was great. Another moment of growth along the road. So I know you'll be all right. I know you'll be all right. There's a little here about her. Let me just state the facts. She's 69, and I'm deeply disturbed that she died that young. It's like someone kidnapped her. She was there with me a little while ago, and then she's gone. The Bible says two will be working in the field, one will be taken, one will be left. Two ladies will be sleeping in the bed, one will be taken, one will be left. It's like kidnapping. Why me here? Why her there? It's something that will take a while to understand. They both passed away from this world, from JFK, where they got very good care. But it's just another testimony, folks, that we don't know everything. And then when it comes to illness and sickness, what we really have to say is we don't know. We just don't know. She was born in, should I even say it, September the 4th, 1951, in Mount Vernon, New York. And she was the daughter of the late Michael and Helen Scola. Helen was Helen Lucchetti. She married her life partnership and best friend, the late Gail Finger, on August the 4th, 2014. And she was unable to let her go. And so she kept her hidden in her heart and in her home. And Barbara was very upset. Where is Gail? And she said Elaine helped her and led her to the place where she had secreted her. And so they could be together here. Now, which is Elaine and which is Gail? You can't know. I assume Gail is on the right and Elaine is on the left because the picture in front of them has it that way. I can give lessons to you as Sherlock Holmes if you would like. Together, they raised a loving family of fur babies happily in their home. Elaine is survived by her brother, Jerry. And her sisters, Linda Peroni and Mary Ann Scola, who are not here. And stepsister, Helen Westover. There are many cousins, a nephew, and a great niece. I do extend our deepest condolences to their family who are far away. And I pray all of us, brethren, that we do not allow momentary passing things in this world to interfere with the things that will last for eternity. Be ye reconciled one to another, my friends, and then talk to God. But don't let things pass. Don't let things become concrete. She was preceded in death by her brother Joseph and her sister, Nancy Ann. Elaine graduated Mount Vernon High School in Mount Vernon, New York, and received a bachelor's degree in psychology and a business administration degree from Mercy College, Dobbs Ferry, New York. Now I know why she liked me. She was a psychologist, and she knew I needed help. She is a very well-educated and successful businesswoman, as was Gail. And you would not be surprised that she specialized in disability insurance because she lived with disability. And she understood the hardships and the challenges of it and the needs that are there. She and Gail. And they had a business. She specialized in these special kind of benefits. And aside from the work that allowed her to fully express her caring for people, she volunteered her time as chairperson for the Family Care Council Agency of Persons with Disabilities. Is there anybody here representing the Agency for Persons with Disabilities? If so, would you please just stand up and let us honor you for a moment? And thank you for your life and for what you do. And may God bless you and keep you. Give them a hand clap, everybody. She would want that, I'm certain. And I'm going to make a full advertisement for the agency. If you can go and follow on the website, you'll see all of the wonderful people who come to the rehabilitation centers, trying to get work for folks, trying to get benefits for folks. And during this time of the pandemic, I have often had special prayers for persons with disabilities and those who care for them who can't get services, who in being isolated become desperate. And I'm glad it's being lifted a little. Seems like a lot of you are running in advance of the church, taking off the mask. That's your choice. But it is a good thing it's passing.
She was a member of the Chambers of Commerce of Palm Beach and many other civic groups. She gave generously of her time and attention in advocacy to those in need. And when I looked at the mission statements and so many of these illnesses that I've never even heard of, but I'm sure people who live with them know full well, it's not what I don't know, it's what I can do to help. That's what makes the difference. That's what makes us Catholic. We don't all agree on everything, but one thing we do is express our faith with love and charity to those in great need. And we do it without concern for persons' life or even belief. The fact that they are breathing makes them a brother and sister. She lived her life to the fullest, with music and poetry and dining and dancing, travel and more. And she shared this with her friends, whom she cherished. I assume that means you. She found great comfort in her faith, and I'm glad to hear that. I didn't write that. She found great comfort in her faith when she joined this church, St. Thomas More Catholic Church. Quote, Elaine spoke often of the kindness she was shown by Pastor Harris during the loss of her wife. We are forever grateful. It is I who am grateful that it is within me to love her and all whom she loves. Elaine will be remembered for her quick wit and her infectious smile, her deep down contagious belly laughter that made us all laugh, and her commitment to making the world a better place, simply because she was here. Her absence will be felt by all who were impacted by her ideals, brilliance, and love. She will be greatly missed also by those who loved her, as she was taken far too early from us. That was given to us by Barbara. It is a testimony of beautiful love, and it includes every one of you. What a privilege and honor it is for us to receive our sister into this chapel, to bless her body, to prepare her for her resting place until Jesus comes, to raise her up, and we'll be a family again together. And until that day, may God watch over you. Amen. Let us pray. Please stand. Father, in baptism, your daughter died with Christ so that she can rise with Christ to share in his eternal life. In thanksgiving, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We give you thanks, O Lord, for the compassionate heart and mind that you gave her, so that reflecting your beauty, your goodness, and your truth, she made this a better world. In thanksgiving, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, she, like all of us, are like sheep and have gone astray at some time in our lives. We beg pardon for her of any failing of her human weakness, and we know that in your tender mercy, you will forgive, forget, and receive her into your loving presence. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for Jared, who is here today to honor his loving sister. And we pray that the Lord, you will watch over him, fill him with joy, help him to grow in maturity, love, and that in his time he will see his sister again. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for all of you who have come to pray, to worship, and to mourn. For blessed are those who comfort the mourning. One day, one will come to you and comfort you in your hour of need. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for an end to violence, distress, here in our streets and across the world, that the people peace of God that seems to be beyond human understanding will come into the hearts of every man and woman. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Now receive, Heavenly Father, these humble gifts of bread and wine which you've asked us to offer, and make them for us the sacrament of our salvation that opens the gates of paradise to Elaine and helps us to who remain to find strength and courage in our fellowship and faith. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated, folks, as I prepare the altar.
That your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Please stand with me, brethren, as we continue our prayers. Heavenly Father, we pray for your daughter, Elaine, that your servant whom you have given the light of faith, and now for whom we offer this sacrifice of conciliation, you will find worthy to join the gathering of the just in your presence. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Give thanks to the Lord our God.
It's right and just.
It's truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation. Always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For in him our hope of the resurrection dawns. The sadness of death gives way to the bright promise of immortality. Lord, for your faithful people, life is changed, not ended, when the dwelling of her earthly body lies before us in death. She's already gained an everlasting dwelling place in heaven. And so we join the angels today and every day of our lives in proclaiming the glory of the Lord.
Oh.
You are indeed holy, Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper had ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us all worthy to be here in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and the blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. With Francis, our Pope, Gerald, our Bishop, and all of the clergy. Remember your servant Elaine Scola, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your son in a death like his, may be one with him now in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who've fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. And all who died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life. Praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Pray with confidence for the coming of the kingdom in the words that the Savior taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Not as the world gives, give I unto you. So let not your hearts be troubled, neither let them be afraid." believe in God. Believe in Elaine. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Turn it off for each other, some sign of fellowship. Peace be with you. Mercy be for us protection in mind and in body, and a healing remedy for our souls. The Lamb of God, Jesus Christ, takes away the sins of the world, and blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof. But only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of our Savior keep Elaine safe unto eternal life. Amen. I will come and give Holy Communion. I'll use this, my mask, and this to place it in your hands. Very careful. If you'd like to receive, I want you to come forward. I'll stand in the center, and then you pass out this side. If you'd like a blessing, just place your hand this way, and I will bless you.
Thank you. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend the soul of your servant Elaine, that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the blessings that you poured out upon her in this life, and the many more blessings that flowed through her to us. They're signs to us of her goodness, and we pray in mercy her fellowship with you and the angels today in paradise. Merciful God, turn toward all who mourn and hear our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to her. Help us who remain here to find comfort in our fellowship and faith until one day we can be with her in the kingdom of heaven, where Christ is Lord forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you. May God be merciful to you, make his face to shine upon you, and grant you his peace. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Mass is ended. Let us go in peace. Thanks be to God. Please stand for the final song. Fellowship for a moment, or go your happy way.